Yo, it's Trevelli. I'm back, and today I'm going to be telling Jets fans three reasons why they need to stop worrying about Zach Wilson after week two. Everything is going to be okay. So if you can, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get this channel out to as many people as possible. Also, follow me on Instagram and Twitter so you get my daily notifications for when I'm dropping videos, which is going to be Monday through Friday because I'm never slacking. Now, let's jump into the action. I'm living life like this. Maybe give a little glimpse, maybe give a little. So we're going to break this down into three major categories why I think that Jets fans who are crucifying Zach Wilson for having five interceptions and having one of the worst TD interception ratios in the league and yada, yada, yada. I don't want to hear it from these Jet fans right now because honestly, you guys have a gem at quarterback. He's just insanely young. The kid is not mature yet. He has no idea what he's doing back there. But these three major categories that I'm going to present to you guys right now should completely eradicate your fears for at least this year and move forward to next year where you guys have the brightest future out of any struggling 0-2 team in the NFL. So let's break down the first category. It's going to be injuries, okay? Obviously, your wide receiver room was decimated going into the season with Jamison Crowder and Keelan Cole not being available for the first two games. You rolled out with Corey Davis, Elijah Moore, Braxton Berrios, and throwing the ball to Tyler Kroft at the tight end spot. Not excited about what I saw from Elijah Moore so far, but I think he obviously has unmatched potential on this team. As far as speed and athleticism goes, should definitely become a favorite for Zach Wilson possibly moving forward, but haven't seen it yet. So the wide receiver core decimated, Mekhi Becton, insanely talented left tackle for this team, gone for the season. So of course, when you have your left tackle out, you're going to be sacked 10 times, which is the worst in the NFL out of any team through two games. And this is going to create the pressure and the havoc that you don't want your rookie quarterback to be under. And if they're at this rate, five sacks a game, 85 sacks in a 17 game season, I don't care who it is. If it's Big Ben in his prime, if it's Cam Newton, you're not going to make it. You're not going to get hit 85 times by NFL linebackers, safeties, and D tackles and make it a full season. So they better shore this up and get things together, or your gem of a rookie quarterback is going to continue to throw interceptions, continue to get hit, and probably be out for the year because they're going to crucify this kid. Number two, he's went against possibly two of the best defenses in the NFL so far, if you look at them statistically speaking. The Panthers, who shut down the high-flying Saints offense, they're only giving up 10.5 points per game, and the Jets didn't even look terrible. They looked better than the Saints did in that game. The Patriots giving up only 11.5 points per game. And of course, you know, Bill Belichick against rookie quarterbacks, he's going to feast on them all day. So just like the injuries played a part, the two teams that he's played against in his opening debut really doesn't help his cause at all. Moving forward, the third and the final reason that Jets fans need to stop worrying is that this is only his second game in the NFL. It's a new system, new coach, okay? It takes time to grow with players, but he still shows insane athleticism. He does need to become more mature, okay? No more errant throws. I'll give you the fact that three of his five picks are bad throws, but two of those were in the hands of his receivers and they didn't help their rookie quarterback out. So all in all, I would say throw this season away, okay? Okay, that's why you don't need to worry because this season's a wrap already. Use it as a learning curve like Flores and the Dolphins did 3 years ago to rebuild their franchise. And even though they're having struggles now, at least look, they had a 10-6 season last year. So you can take that and say, okay, that's kind of how you want to mold your team. You get more picks in the draft to build the O-line and the running back room. And this team could be deadly if they are healthy moving forward. Do not under any circumstance throw away the gem that you have here. Bad start, of course, but what did you expect? You have a new head coach, new quarterback, new left tackle, injuries on both sides of the ball, and one of the worst rosters in football. It's going to be a dumpster fire this year, but if you give it time, maybe 6-11 next year, and who knows, maybe the playoffs by 2023 is a possibility for this team. So I need Jets fans to go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. Even though I am a Dolphin fan, but this is an honest opinion from, you know what, let's be real. The Dolphins and the Jets have sucked for so long that the rivalry at this point is, you know, we all hate the Patriots. And now that the Bills are the new dynasty, let's all team up here. I'm telling you guys, don't worry. I was there 3 years ago when the Dolphins were the worst team in the league and they opened up versus Baltimore and got blasted, I think like 52 or 59-7, something like that. But whatever it was, The point is, guys, you guys are going to be okay. Just like they say in New York, take it easy. Everything's going to be fine and peace. I'm living life like this. Maybe give a little glimpse, maybe give a little.